Well, hello there, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to another episode of Story Time. I'm having a lovely Hey, horse, get back in your pit. Why are you out of your pit? I'll kill your face. I'm having a great day. I hope you guys are having a lovely day as well. Ouch! And, I'm just excited. I've got a lot to talk about today. This episode should be a very fun as soon as I get this horse back into his pit. But, yeah, I think it's going to be a little bit of a talky episode because, get on there, gay face. Don't you dare. Because I've just got some questions that I'd like some, I got some questions that I'd like some help with and stuff. I've got a couple series, I don't know what the plural is, going on my channel, and I think I'm going to have a hard time keeping up with everything, so I just like everybody to kind of be able to say which ones they think they like more, which ones they like less. I started doing some tutorials. It seems like that seems to be something that you guys dig, so maybe I'll continue that. I really like the story time, and I'll probably do that, but like I have a bee haven. Ooh, I changed this. It looks like it's bent down and such. I've got some more ideas some people have given me on this about, you know, I've got a little pile of rocks there. I think I'm going to change this up a bit, and then I started putting a house here, just doing like regular framing for the houses. Like this one here is kind of done, and it's kind of the look. I'll get to that chimney thing in a second. You know, did a couple more here, just going on a rant. You can get some of the heights and the sizes of these buildings here as you walk through. I want you to be able to be in here and feel like you're in a town, you know. So I've got a lot of work to do there, but like I said, I'll do most of that off of the camera. But what was I talking about? Oh, the video game series. So I like to keep this one going because I think people are liking this one, and this is probably one of my more favorite to record. Yummy! So yeah, just let me know what you think of what I'm doing with the channel, and we'll just try to keep getting videos out there that you guys want to watch. Okay, so you'll see, and I did a tutorial on it, this little fireplace in the corner. And I know people right now are shouting at their computer and shaking their hands violently in the air, going, "You are dumb. This is the desert. There's no reason for them to have a fireplace in their house." Well, guys, I don't know if any of you guys have actually spent a night in the desert. I go on a somewhat yearly rock climbing trip out into the high deserts in California, and it is a very, very cold at night. Very, very hot during the day, but super, super cold at night. So I'm going to be adding little fireplaces and chimneys through these houses because it is cold in the desert at night, and they need to be able to heat their house in some way. Shut up, horse, enjoy your pit. Anyways, on with it, they say. So today, guys, I want to start working on this little, because we did the stone quarry. That's how they're getting stones for the houses. But I want to work on this little building here. It's going to have a water wheel in it, and one of my buddies, Creator B, over at I Play Blockhead, he gave me this awesome idea for a saw. So this is going to be like the little water wheel powered sawmill, because they use wood in this town along with the stone, and one way to move wood around back in the olden times is to float it down these rivers and such. So maybe they're floating wood down these rivers in the little oasis here, and this guy's, you know, collecting them. Maybe there's a spot cut out right here where there's like logs floating, and he's pulling them up into his building and he's sawing them up so people can use them in their builds and whatnot. So I'll be building that. Thank you, Creator B, for the idea. You guys will see it momentarily. But I wanted to talk a little bit about story. I've got some ideas. Chris Bud threw an idea out again about having having the people over here in the mansion, and we were talking about them be kind of like spies for the evil king Aronius. But he said something about them being in the shipwreck, and I don't think I'm gonna have them be part of the shipwreck. because that no one really knows anything about that. But yeah, so maybe in an episode or two, I could just see a big house up there and everybody's over here in the town all poor and dirty. And they look over there and they're like, hey, you stinkers. And why do you have all the monies and stuff? So that'll be kind of fun. And I think it'll be a cool little design. But back to the story. So we left off and we were here getting ready to be hungified by our neck. They weren't going to chop our head off, but hungified by our neck because we are a traitor, because we're wearing the color of the evil king Argonius, and they think that we're part of the bad king's plan to do evil things and hurt people. So here's where the story's going to go. So we're all here. The town is gathered. They're gathered here. Imagine it. They're gathered here, and they're getting ready, and someone's up here going, oh, blah, 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 blah. I'm going to kill you. But right before they do that, there's a hangman, and he rips away our ratty clothing to show a branding on our shoulder, a branding of an X. Dun, dun, dun. And that branding is the branding that they give prisoners. So by ripping away our shirt and seeing that we are branded a prisoner, people realize that, oh no, he didn't know who he was on this ship, and it's because he wasn't part of the evil king's, you know, plan. We were captured and branded a prisoner, and we were prisoner above on the ship. And that is where we're going to take the story, and that is how we got out of this sticky situation. So now the story goes, you know, wreck the ship, get brought over here to be hungified, and oh no, now we're not a bad guy, and we get to roam around the town, meeting the townsfolk, and getting information, trying to lead to where our story is. So there's an update on that. I think it's a really, really cool idea. Let me know what you think. So we're going to be exploring more of the town and building more of the town in a couple more episodes, but there's an update on the story. Get on with it, they say. So I'm going to get building a little bit here and try to get some ideas worked out for this sawmill. And there you have it, guys. So sit back and enjoy the turning of these pages. All right, we start off with a little bit of dirt, move on to some stone, start throwing the floor down and getting an idea. Got a little roof going on there now, and starting to come together. Let's throw a water wheel on it, and blammo! Dang it! Stinking check my recording stuff and a creeper blowify all of this stuff up. I hate them! I hate them with a passion! Oh, poopy. Oh, let's get this, get some sand in here and start filling her back in. Stupid creeper hole. Hate them. Hate stupid creepers. Well, anyways, I think it's recording well now. It just wasn't doing what I thought it was doing. So I had a great idea while I was making my buildification. And that was, I talked just a little bit ago about how we were... Oh, I've got gold armor on. Stupid. Take the armor off so they can see. I wish you could actually, like, turn this guy in your settings, like, in your screen here, and you could see his backside. But, ba-bam. I've been marked with an X, and that is the king marking me as a prisoner. But, I think that it would be cool if, because it's the king Aronius, and I think it would be cool if... King Aronius marked his, because remember how I had said before, like, the Dahlstrom family, they're taking his sons, and they're making them slaves so that the king can find this, well, we don't know what it is yet, what the king is searching for. So maybe the slaves or the prisoners are marked with an A for Aronius. Pretty good idea. That's what I'm talking about. Let me know what you think. I think, you know, maybe the X or the A, you know. X is just marking them as a prisoner, or maybe the A marking them as property of, you know, King Aronius. Well, I think I fixed that up enough. What was I showing you? Well, what was it? My brain. On with it, they say. So here we are. we've got a little spot here that that we tend to throw cactuses. But the logs come in here, and maybe a little stream or a little bit of water flow, and kind of collect them from different parts. You could, you know, they could be collected from either side. They could use like poles and stuff. Maybe I should. Maybe there's a pole that's like sticking here. I need a fence. There's two. Will that get me a good enough looking pole? I don't want it to stick to anything. I can put it around the corner. Oh, half slab, you ruined my life, half slab. Something that they would use to, you know, kind of guide these logs up into here, where I'm thinking about, get up there, stupid. I'm thinking about maybe attaching something that's like a pulley. And they used to pull them up into here. They slide them. I know there's some different colors in here. I haven't distressed this yet or begun to make it unique in any way. I'm just getting like the framework. I like how there's a couple gears here that have this like shaft, so to speak, that's running the gears, that's running the saw. This is not the saw that my buddy Creator B showed me. He showed me one that actually cuts back and forth with two pistons, one pushing one way, one pushing the other way, and it looks very cool. I couldn't get the timing right, and I'll talk to him and maybe we can work something out, but I couldn't get the timing right, and I was thinking that would be for cutting the wood this direction, and when you're making boards, you'd want to cut it this way to make these boards so that they could use them on the houses. On with it. And then over here, like, I want to add something in here, like, I mean, I don't think I could do a fence. Yeah, because it just kind of sits. Well, what if I did a fence that went underneath those? That went in there. Oh, I think I may like that. Let's do that. Let's do that right now. Oh, exciting. Okay, so, broop, broop, beep. That'll work for that. And then we do broop. Like so, maybe another one. Yes. Oh, I need one more. Boop. Beep doop. I think that'll be enough. I can't jump that. I can go in here, though. Jumping and running, jumping and running. Alright, so come in here, and I go, yeah, booba. Come in here, and I gotta go up from here. There it is. Yes. 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 Breathe. Did I breathe? I did it. That's all of them. Perfect number. Swim. I need to be up here. Jump! That is weird. You guys see that? The flow flows around that block. It's a path block. That's strange. They need to fix that. It doesn't look right. Yeah, I like it. It gives it a little bit of wooden structure. You know what it needs to be? It needs to be a different color of wood. Yes. I gotta start to change things up. I need some variety in the wood in here. I need to distress the top a little bit. I'm gonna put walls around the gear house, so to speak. This little area here I figured would be like the gear house that kind of runs all of the mechanism and stuff. But yeah, just kind of change things up, age it a little bit. I'm probably gonna move this over, or maybe along this wall where it's, well, no, it needs to be right here. It needs to be a little, I mean, think about it. Someone's going to stand here, and this is the side they're going to be on. So, you know, flip your switch, your saw's running, have something here, load up your next log. You know, they pull it out through here, they cut it, and they stack it up here. I need a little bit of a loading dock here for them to be able to move stuff around. I got to clear out some of this stuff because it just doesn't make sense. And then to get it into the town, they would have to have pulled it around here. So there needs to be a path. And then up and over here. It's a little bit of a long way around, but that's how they had to do it. So there you go, guys. There's a little update on the progress. I think we're coming along really, really good with this. And I should be able to finish it up pretty quick. I had a couple more ideas about killing squid. And you think we use a bow and we should killify them. Die. I don't think you work well. Can you shoot down through water? Is this a thing that happens in life?
Yes.
Abso-friggin-lutely. So I'm thinking about story, because I'm always thinking about the story, and where to go to next, because I don't want to stick around too much in one spot. I'd like this to be... Oh, I hit my leg! I like this to be constantly moving and constantly changing. You know, we've done quite a bit of work here in the town, you know, once I finish this build off. But the storyline, so here's my idea, and you guys can obviously give me feedback. Earlier on in an earlier episode, I talked about right there, you can actually see it from here, having a lighthouse, because this is the bay in which the ships would come in to bring in, I'm gonna die if I don't eat something. I need to eat. Where the ships would bring in supplies and they would ship out supplies and stuff like that. I'm getting food. Hey, horse pit. And, you would need a lighthouse, right? On with it. Talk with your face. And, I thought about building the lighthouse and I wanted to have it, and. Stop saying and. I wanted it to have some kind of significance. There's and again. What is wrong with me? Anyways, there's going to be someone in this town, I'm guessing, or I'm making up, it's make-believe, that is going to tell us about a kooky old man that lives in the top of the lighthouse. And he is like this super old guy that, you know, no one knows like where he was born or where he came from. He's older than the town. He's older than sand and dirt. But... they're like, maybe you should go talk to him. You know, he knows a lot. I don't know, maybe I'll build it on top of this. It seems like it should be out closer to the water, but it's got to be up in the air. So, yeah, it would make sense for it to be built on top of this. And it would be a great eye catcher for when you're, like, coming in. There's the path coming into town. I still have to bridgeify that gap. So we got to think about this old man. I had thoughts to think that he was a wizard. And maybe what the king is looking for is these sacred items, Eyes of Ender, that lead you to a special place. And there's so many of them, and they're guarded and throughout the world. And they were, you know, maybe guarded by a number of wizards that are protecting the secret. And he's one of those, and if you talk to him, maybe he'll lead you towards getting these special items, and we can beat the king to whatever awesome stuff is you know, awaiting us in certain land. I don't know. Those are some ideas. I think that's kind of a fun storyline, so now we have to, like, try to race the king and find the items before he does. Anyways, I'm going to sleep, and we will be right back at you. In the turn of our page. Beep, boop. Nailed it. All right there, guys. Now let's take a look at what I've done. I think I'm happy for the moment. I've started just to add all sorts of little details. You've got your little crane thing that helps you put a couple pieces on top. Yes, and give it a little more support. And then I distressed the roof a little bit, and I added a little tree in the front. I think that's cool. I did the colors in there, and, you know, all around, just kind of finished off the build. There's still some little finishing touches to do, but I've put a lot of time into it today. I gotta, you know, finish a little walkway, because he's gonna have a little path that you can walk down here to get, you know, to get down to it, because no one actually lives here. Get up here. Nice. And this is what I was just thinking with my brain. Maybe go with these. Even just that would make it look beefier. Beefier to make it look like it's stronger. Strong like bull. Yeah, a little bit. Yeah, I like it. And it looks like just a little spool of rope or something that they were able to hook onto the logs and yankify them up into the air. Made it more like a little dock here. So it's like it hangs over the water. A little bit of a guard here. You've got a little workstation. We got chopping of the wood. The gear is kind of underneath the stairs in the gear house. You go up into the gear house, and this is where I'm going to just have the wood stored. Any wood that I'm going to use for the town will be up here. Give me a way to start storing some things and sorting. Here's the stacks of lumber, and I got to go ahead and make the pathway and make it where it kind of fits the working part of the town. They'll have to be able to pull their lumber up and around here to get it to the town. But there you have it, guys. That was a pretty fun build. Let me know what you think. Give me some feedback. I feel like these buildings, are cool and it's like the style of this town, but could be lacking something. So if you guys have any ideas about what I may be missing, let's get a shot from the bridge. Yeah, I tell you what, looking at it from right there, that could be a screenshot right there. I know, but I want to have the water wheel in the screenshot. Time for a screenshot. Oh yeah. Yeah. Like this, maybe get a little closer. Oh, there it is. Azah, it is. And you even get you get in the background the hangman's noose, but there we are. And a ka-chink. Perfect. All right, guys. I thank you so very, very much for watching this episode. But it is time for me to get going. Stay tuned for more story time, but we may never know where the story will take us. But one thing's for sure, I'll be back.
See ya, fellas. Amazing.